Brisbane is the capital of Queensland, but it isn't as bustling or chaotic as other Australian cities. If anything, it isn't chaotic at all. Despite the concrete pavements and tangled streets, life here seems to move at a gentle pace. We discovered something pleasant at every turn. What's more, many of these can be enjoyed at no or little cost. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Josh. In this video, we'll take you to some of the top tourist spots you shouldn't miss if you plan to visit Brisbane soon. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. The tallest mountain within the general Brisbane area, Mount Kutha, is best known as a magnificent lookout. From here, you'll get a fantastic view of the Central Business District's buildings towering over the city. As you explore the viewing deck, you can read about the history of the city. You can also use a telescope installed on site for a closer look. Aside from the viewpoint, locals also come to Mount Kutha for its bushwalking trails and gardens. It's also a popular picnic spot among locals. To get here, take TransLink Bus 4721 from Adelaide Street in CBD. Uber and taxi will cost around $23 and $37 respectively. Lone Pine is one of the few places on Earth where you can interact and have a photo holding a koala. Established in 1927, it takes pride in being the world's first and largest koala sanctuary and conservation site. According to the staff, it has been a home for rescued koala. There's also a vast space for kangaroos and wallabies. Guests can have photos taken while holding a koala for an additional fee. I felt no need for having to hold them, but it's still up to you. To get here, you may take bus 430 from Platform 2C at Queen Street Station or bus 445 from Stop 41 on Adelaide Street. Entrance fee is $36, but Cloak sells tickets at a discounted price. There's no better way of seeing the city than through the eyes of a local, and the government of Brisbane believes that too. Brisbane Greeters is an ambassador service wherein locals volunteer to give visitors a tour of the city. And yep, for free! You can choose the program or you can let the greeter make the decision for you, but rest assured that they will try their best to make the tour enjoyable and hassle-free. There are over 100 greeters as of today with 20 languages available. We joined one. Our friendly and knowledgeable guide led us to key historic spots around CBD and then across the river to the South Banks. Reservation is required. You can do that on the official Brisbane website. You know you're in the South Bank parklands when the 42 gondola wheel of Brisbane towers above you. Opened to the public in 1992, this complex of plazas, restaurants, greens, and rainforest cover what used to be the site of the World Expo 88. There's a lot to see here, including the Nepal Peace Pagoda, constructed by a German architect, as part of the Kingdom of Nepal's participation in the expo. Visitors may also choose to walk around and enjoy the scenery at the Riverfront Promenade and the Grand Arbor, a kilometer-long bougainvillea canopied arch pergola that covers a pedestrian walkway linking the cultural forecourt to the Griffith Film School. On the way back to the hostel from Kangaroo Point, we passed through South Bank Parklands once again, but our attention was stolen by an acoustic act happening in one of the greens. Brisbane's music scene has been exploding over the past years, and if you know where to go, you can actually join a gig at no cost. Oh, if you're dining here, beware of these birds, and they steal people's food. Part of the South Bank Parklands, the Streets Beach is a unique man-made lagoon next to the Brisbane River. Being here gives that illusion that you have left the metropolis, but it is the only beach within a city in all of Australia. It is a swimming beach, complete with glittering white sand, fringed with tropical trees. Swimming is allowed. Over the past years, Brisbane has seen pop-up markets sprout in its streets and parks. Those showcasing clothing and art in particular have enjoyed popularity among locals and tourists alike. Explore one and you might find something that matches your taste, from quirky trinkets to handmade accessories, and vintage souvenirs to limited edition art pieces. Here's a short list of weekend markets. There are also food markets around town selling fresh organic produce, quick bites, delectable desserts, and baked goods. You can also have barbecue picnic with friends. Kangaroo Point offers not only fantastic vistas of the Brisbane River and the Central Business District, but also free use of grills and tables situated atop the cliffs. Lying between Ann and Adelaide Streets, King George Square is one of the city's most visited public squares. It is surrounded by many recognizable landmarks, including the Brisbane City Hall, a recently refurbished building that you may explore on a free guided tour. Don't miss Brisbane Museum and the Clock Tower just around the corner. Entertaining over 26 million visitors a year, the Queen Street Mall is said to be the most popular pedestrian mall in Australia. Situated adjacent to City Hall and just across King George Square, it is a vibrant lifestyle destination at the heart of the Central Business District. Flanking its streets are more than 700 choices of apparel stores, restaurants, and souvenir shops. Don't forget to make a stop at these places. Riverlife promotes itself as a lifestyle and entertainment playground. Situated on the bank of Brisbane River and at the base of Kangaroo Point Cliffs, they provide a fantastic venue for many functions and adventures. For tourists, Riverlife is best known for the many extreme activities it offers. We've tried rappelling before, also known as abseiling in this part of the world, and we had a blast! The view from the top of the cliff was fantastic, and our instructor was entertaining, and the activity itself, unforgettable. Here are some of the activities they offer. They provide all the equipment needed for these activities. In the case of abseiling, it includes harness, helmet, rope, and gloves. But these are not the only extreme activities you can try in Brisbane. You can also climb to the top of the Story Bridge. There are only 3 bridge climbs in the world, at least that we know of, and Brisbane Story Bridge is one of them. Or if that's not high enough for you, how about skydiving? Surprisingly, tandem skydiving in Brisbane isn't as expensive as in most countries. Jump out of a plane at 15,000 feet up in the air and enjoy free falling while enjoying spectacular views of the continent and the ocean. With a partner professional skydiver, of course. You'll be landing on a beach. This is definitely an experience that will give you memories for keeps. ANZAC is an acronym for the Australian and New Zealand Army Corps. And these monuments around the country pay tribute to everyone who has served Australia in the great wars that she has participated in. And yes, there's one in Brisbane too. Rejoice, bookworms and poetry fans! Time to go for a walk. And a walk in Brisbane can be as educational and inspiring as it is relaxing. Brisbane's Albert Street is punctuated by 32 brass plaques installed on the pavement, all bearing literary quotes from 32 Queensland writers who have lived in the city at one point in their lives. The trail was launched at the 1996 Brisbane Writers Festival. These are just some of the authors whose words are immortalized along Albert Street. The oldest park in Brisbane, this was once a land tended by convicts to produce crops for the prison colony but was later transformed into a public space for recreation. Situated by the river, it allows a great view of the skyline, serves as a perfect picnic venue, and offers great walking and biking lanes. Two of the most visited sections are the Bamboo Grove, which showcases 23 bamboo species, and the Weeping Fig Avenue, planted in the 1870s. Other attractions include the ornamental ponds and the Jemmy Morrill and the Brolga sculpture. You may take a free guided walking tour available from Monday to Saturday. Australia is known for their love of beer. Brisbane is no different. Here, the most iconic brand is this. Its history stretches 135 years, making it an icon. Klook's 90-minute tour will take you around the brewery and introduce to you the brand's ingredients and brewing methods. The tour ends with a beer tasting session. It's a must for beer lovers. If you need more information about traveling around Australia, you'll find comprehensive travel guides with sample itineraries on our website, www.thepoortraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, make good use of the comment section below. You can also follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoortraveler_L. You may also tune in to the Poor Traveler podcast on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.